Pendo. Raquel Pendo is a new media artist. She developed a PhD thesis in new media in urban spaces. Part of her research was presented in seminars at Buenos Aires University, Plymouth University, and University of Sunset, among others. Together with Rafael Marchetti, she developed projects at the Digital Arts Duo Influenza. The website is www.influenza.etc.br. This links are on our OSP, if you go there. Not there, it would be. They are not there. I think that they are. I'm going to check. In 2005, Raquel and Rafael developed the installation Non-Sensor at Cypress Institute, directed by Libet in France, sponsored by UNESCO, Cypress, and the Ministry of Culture of Brazil. From 2005 to 2007, she was artist and researcher in residence at Media Lab Madrid, now Media Lab Prado in Madrid. Some projects by Influenza won awards at FIO, at programming festivals, and in 2005, some of Influenza's works were exhibited at ACN in Singapore, Togo Bow Gallery, Individual Gallery in Marseille, France, Coma Fosca at Barcelona, Nuevas Geografias in Mexico, Armenia and Ljubljana and many other places, Cuba, Arte Electronica Links, among other places. Now she is researcher of ICA, Institut Català d'Antropologia, at Griggs Group de Recerca en Exclusión y Control Social at the University of Barcelona, and partner of the architecture studio fund, where she develops studies on urban planning. She is also participating of a collective cultural association called Aerostatic. Raquel, now we have more people here. And we can today we are not going to have the same presentation with the projector behind the person. We are going to have a software called TeamViewer, and then we are allowed to see her computer in our projection. Okay, Raquel, we start now. And we can have a break, 10, 15 minutes break, and then, oh, sorry, you start, what? And you start, he starts after this break. Okay? Yes?
Yes.
Okay, I'm not sure if the sound is good.
Might work better without the mic.
Yeah, because I'm going to try to find a good point here without the microphone.
Okay. First of all, thank you, Jenny. Thank you, Susan. Thank you, Brett, for inviting me and being here. And thank you with your computer to this presentation. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, I just want you to talk a bit about Influenza, which is a project I have with Rafael Marchetti. Influenza is a research project that began with my studies in semiotics and urban spaces, combined with the experience of Rafael Marchetti, which is an artist and also a programmer, which also the name Influenza, based on the Gloria and the song Language of Survivors from the 80s, which come as well from the reflection of William Burroughs, that in the electronic revolution said that the only way to fight against media domination would be by creating language violence.
I don't think that the microphone is a good
So we decided to use the name Cleanser, which is, well, the clue. And, okay. Basically, the proposal is to understand and investigate a bit about the communicative pollution, noise, and the inclusion of noise in the communication system. So how does it change information, make it more complex and rich in means? So we decided to study it in different environments. In terms of academic studies, but also in terms of digital art projects. So, at first I have to show some examples of people who also work with noise and hoax and everything that disturbs information. Well, I showed you, there are many examples, and I just chose two that I like very much. One is Alameco. I would like to show a small video about of his work. This one, for example, was the one where he called some newspapers saying that he was part of an organization called Citizens Against Breastfeeding and wanted to abolish breastfeeding, basically. And so it had a great repercussion in international media, even though he's doing this for since the 60s, the 70s. So and there's still people talking about it on media, saying that there's a real group trying to ban breastfeeding. So this is something that really interested me because how the work of this kind of artists, they still are very effective, even if there are news in the newspaper saying there is a lie, that it's a professional hoaxer. And so they're all very interesting. You should take a look at his website and also the film, which is very interesting as well. And also, there is a work of Spanish artist called Joan Coberta. Well, this is part of the text that was presented in the art galleries and also the catalog. And so it talks about this Ivan Stolichkov, a Russian cosmonaut who, we are told, disappeared during the flight of Soyuz 2 in 68 and was then removed from history by Soviet bureaucracy. And so photographs were retouched to remove his life. And his family was moved to Siberia, his friends and colleagues were threatened. But in fact, what happened is that, okay, just let me go back because, in fact, he researched the topic for years in space museums in the US, started a film interviewing foreign cosmonauts, and he faked the materials, which he presented in Madrid in 1997. So family photos, publicity shots, newspapers, articles, documentary material in the US Soviet space race. And in fact, it wasn't very good. It's not that it was an artist in terms of creating very good fake things. It was just the information that was all combined together in an art gallery that was that made it work so impressive. And till now, last year, for example, there was a TV program in Spain who presented the case, not saying that it was something happened, but saying that that was the case of this astronaut from Russia. And so 11 years after his work was officially presented in a gallery, there are still people, journalists, thinking that what he did was true. So this for me was something that was very, very interesting. So based on this artist project, we decided to study urban spaces because this is something that I've been doing in the last years. And we wanted to understand a bit about noise in this specific environment. This is a picture of what it was like, which will be presented in in June in Alagoda, which is an art center in Gijón, in Spain. It's an installation where we use noise from the street, working with noise from the gallery, and we create a patchwork of images from the grid, and also this line that there is a lack of noise that covers all our images. So we started to understand that in biology and theory of communication, the concept of noise is seen as a rich element in information. So we tried to translate it in terms of the urban environment. So where there's a continuous struggle between social flows or social groups and urban planning, as you know. Normally, urban planning, in a traditional way, tries to organize the city and also organize social flow. And social flow is constantly changing urban planning. And so we wanted to understand it in terms of new maps and new digital art, because we thought there was something very powerful to inspire the kind of work we are doing. So we did basically two, in fact four, but I can shift it now from Marco to pixels, because Martin was practicing installation, so I cannot show it because we don't have any documentation yet. And also we came up with it. So just to give a brief introduction. This project was done in Brazil at the time we were living in São Paulo, which is a city with about 15 to 8 million inhabitants. And we started to understand how people live in the city, because the city is huge, but normally people just move from one neighborhood to the other. They don't really know cities, a typical city where you live your whole life and still know the city in the whole. So we wanted to understand and wanted to express a bit about this fragmented way to experience the city and run away from all these stereotyped conceptions, because according to mass media, there is just only good places to see where we find in the cultural part of the touristic part of newspapers and magazines. And when we talk about violence and everything, they just concentrate in some neighborhoods. So it gave us a stereotyped vision of the city. When in fact, everything is neat, everything is overpopulated, we have a lot of people, the violence is everywhere. So we wanted to express a bit about this experience in a kind of ironic way. So developed this project. This is my art project. So this is basically some patterns took from a satellite image of São Paulo, okay? And then we worked with a database, but a database that didn't mean anything, in fact. It's just like when you're walking in a street of a city like that, where it's, you know, a lot of things happening at the same time, when you have all the experience that you cannot understand very well what's happening, because everything's happening at the same time. And everything is mixed, so I have a lot of parallels. And we wanted to experience this in a digital arts environment. So we create this kind of new map that is covering the original map of the city. And there are some concepts like wasteland, typical pictures you see where you can see everything organized by the photographer. But more like this photograph you took when you were in a bus. Or just walking around when you don't really have everything on focus. So you have everything together. So you can, if you click for double click it, you can see it would be very good size. But if you still keep clicking and you create like a map, a personal map over the original map. So basically that's the idea of the website. It's a bit slow, but I think you got the picture. So after this project, we did another one in Madrid. We were at Linz for the Ars Electronica, and they were presenting the weekly map Linz. I don't know if you heard about Linz, but it's in Austria, and it's a very small town. And in Austria, the urban planning is very controlled, and so the weekly map there was very poor in our opinion, because the city didn't offer much. Was everything very symmetrical, everything is a bit similar, all of the path and the way were respected, and there are not many people there living there anyway. So we said it, we mentioned it to Gerhard Stocker, which is the director of the Ars Electronica, and he said, okay, so if you think you can do better, maybe you should try to do it in Madrid, which is a 5 million inhabitant city with a lot of immigrants, a lot of illegal immigrants, and a lot of things going on, parties. And so it's, for us it was like a challenge to do it. We liked the idea, so we decided to do it in middle of Madrid with Ars Electronica. So, okay, just let me see if I... No. Well, the project was designed by Raphael with like 2 weeks discussions with people from Madrid, people who are working with free wireless connection, internet connection, and also groups were working with people from the streets, collectives, and urban planners, architects, to understand what should this street map be. So basically, there's a distinction. The plan of the city can be something more than the representation of streets and buildings by means of the wiki map, digital images, personal impressions, sounds, stories, and the landscapes imagined by both inhabitants and visitors to the city would all form part of the map. So wiki map is a virtual map on which users link images and sounds to specific map as if they were hypertext on a web page. Thus, it is possible for participation in urban dynamics to move from the virtual to the actual. The aim of this project is to develop a flexible, accessible multimedia environment that contributes to the creation of collective citizens' memory by means of multiplicity of subjective visions, which can have a huge variety of cultural, social, education users, etc. So, just have a look at the project. So basically, you have a map of the city, and you can zoom in, zoom out. It should take a while. And basically, there are image, text, sound, and also we had a project. The original Wikimap links didn't have projects, but as we had the discussion with these groups, they were actually working in the streets of Madrid. We proposed to have a project and to link places and people. So, you can have an idea how widespread they were. And anyone can add a text, image, sound, or a project, or even delete someone else's post. So we have like kinds of information. You have very individual information about people who are just talking about their home, or they just recorded the birds outside their window and put it here and say, oh, this is wonderful, I can hear the birds in the morning. Some people just, like this one, explain what happens in the neighborhood, to take a picture and say, oh, this is very typical, there are many kinds of this urban art in the zone. And also we have people just saying, oh, this is a wonderful park, we're going to have a beer, oh, the food here is very nice. And also you can have people who are just talking about URLs and works that were done for by groups work there. I'm sorry, it's a bit slow, but
Hello? You can. You can also choose what you want to see or what you want to hide, and you can see where you are in the city. It's like a representation of the city. And you can also search for keywords. So basically, this is your original project presented in Digital Transit, which were an exhibition combining artists from Austria and projects from Austria and projects from Madrid. And this one was basically a Media Madrid Arts Electronica project. And after this first project, we had many others we met. We are doing some for a small city in Catalonia. There are other people doing this for a neighborhood in a more complex way in Madrid. So it goes on and on, and now we really like it. There are some people working with OpenStreetMap. I don't know if you've heard about the OpenStreetMap project. It's a project that started in England. And there are a very strong group in Spain. So basically, they go to places, distribute GPS to people, and everybody goes, walking or by car with a GPS. And they, after a week, they come together and they design a map. It's completely free map. And also, if it changes, it's not like this one where you have to follow the streets and the typical map design. You can just do your own map, if you, like you're a pedestrian, so you don't have to respect the streets, because you can pass in the middle of some houses, and this is, a quicker way to go to a neighborhood that you like, so to go to a park, to go to a bar area, so you can design it in a OpenStreetMap, and it's changeable. It's a very, very strong tool, and it's have been used by a group that started the discussion with us at the Media Lab of it, and then connected to people from the OpenStreetMap with Steve, who basically was the mentor of the OpenStreetMap project, and that's basically what we're doing. The last year, basically. So this is very important in terms of Spain, because Spain is one of the few countries in the European Union where all the map information are not free yet. So you have to follow the rules, even if they allow you to use the map. You cannot change it. So OpenStreetMap is very important in this case, and also there are a lot of people, young people, come together and understanding how important it is to have your own map, to use the information in terms of coding, but also in terms of putting your own memory, seeing how the things are changing, how they destroy
so it's a way of seeing the change and seeing it in a different way. It's not like the typical way when you just come back to a neighborhood and say, oh my God, this is all changed, it's all destroyed. Now you have a skyscraper where the small buildings, now you can track it. And you can have like a report of how the city is changing, which is something very, very important in a political way. So basically, this weekend is an example of how you can start in a very humble way with a flash map, posting text and photographs. But if you can make people come together and understand what the project is about and make it a collective project, it can bless and help. In a way that you can have control. But this is what is important when you're talking about urban space and technology. So after that, in terms of research, came to a chill phase where I was reading Prigozhin and Maturana and Varela. And I decided to understand a bit about noise, science, and arts. So this is a very nice creature. Unfortunately, it's small, but the original is huge. And it's called the Lepidotoides infernalis. And, well, I'll talk about this creature and the project of Louis Beck, because I think it's very important. And it gives a good example about noise in science and arts. So this is something that I found in the banquet of Plato. Normally we criticize the Greeks very quickly, and sometimes we don't pay attention on how they express some ideas or how there are some interesting ideas in what they wrote. And for me, it was interesting to see that there was a discussion in the book, the banquet, that there are people just eating together.